thermodynamics, this is the first part of this course. In chapter one, we have an introduction to the thermodynamics. We talk about the temperature, about the thermal expansion, and ideal gas. In general, first of all, we talk about the temperature, the definition of heat, and the internal energy. And we go to the ideal gases, which can be described by the pressure P in Pascal, by the volume V, and temperature T. Let's define, first of all, the heat. The notation of heat is Q, the unit in joule. In general, the heat is an exchange of energy from one system to another. Let's take a medium A. This one, it can be solid, liquid, or gas. If we give a quantity of energy to the system. So in this case, we have an exchange of energy between the external medium and a medium. So we have Q. As the energy is added to the system, we have to say Q hat, and it must be positive. And we say here that the energy is gained or absorbed by the system. And if we release a quantity of energy out of the system, so Q is called Q cold. It must be negative. And the energy is released by the system out. So here we have Q hot and we have Q cold. In this case, the system of the energy is gained by the system, and here the energy is released by the system. Here we have three kinds of system. We have open system, closed system, and isolated system. In the case of open system, where we can add and we can release, we can get out a quantity of molecules. It's open. Now, N is not constant. And also, we can easily have an exchange of energy. So we have Q. In the case of open system, we have Q and we have N. In the case of closed system, we cannot add N. So N must be constant inside the system because it's closed. But the wall of the system is not isolated. So we can get an exchange of energy between the internal medium and the external medium. In this case, we have Q. As we have exchange of energy, so we have Q. If the energy is gained by the system, we can say Q is hot. If the energy is released by the system, we can say Q is cold. In the last case, in the case of isolated system, in this case, we cannot add N, so N inside must be constant, and we don't have an exchange of energy between the internal and external medium. So we don't have Q and we don't have N through the wall of the system. But here, be careful. I can insert a resistance inside the medium. And by using this resistance, we can heat the system. We can have an exchange of heat between this resistance and the internal medium. But we don't have an exchange of energy through the wall of the medium. Okay, here we can get Q hat, which is gained by the internal medium. Here, I want to explain the thermal contact and the thermal equilibrium. If we have an exchange of energy between two objects, so we have a thermal contact. In the case of no exchange of energy between the objects, so we have a thermal equilibrium. Let's take initially, we have an isolated system. We have, in general, we have an exchange of energy if we have a difference of temperature between the objects, like this case. Here we have TA equals to 50 and TB equals to 30. So A will lose a quantity of heat, Q cold. This quantity of heat will be absorbed by B. B will gain a quantity of heat, so we have Q hat. Q cold lost by A will be gained by B. So the absolute value of Q hat equals to the absolute value of Q cold. Without absolute value, you know Q cold must be negative. So Q hat equals to minus Q cold. Okay, as a final state, when we have a thermal equilibrium, as a final state, we have a constant temperature, TA equals to TB. In this case, we don't have an exchange of energy between A and B, so we don't have Q. So Q equals to zero between them. In this case, we can say we have a thermal equilibrium between A and B or of the system. And T final of A and B must be between 50 and 30. Why? Because TA will decrease, TB will increase, and we arrive to the point between TA and TB. It will be between 50 and 30.